Hello, my name is Katie Purcell. I'm an applications engineer here at Achronix, and today I'm going to introduce you to the Achronix tools through a simple quick start design. First, you'll copy over the quick start design into your work area. Then I'll show you how to create a project with Synplify Pro, add source files, and synthesize the design. Then finally, I'll go through creating an ACE project to finish up the place and route and create a bitstream. Each release of ACE includes our quick start example design. On Linux, you can copy the files from your ACE installation directory under Achronix Linux /examples/quickstart/device name. There's a separate set of design files for each device since the constraints can be different. On Windows, just browse to your installation directory and you can copy files from examples/quickstart/device directory. You should have all the source files you need, including the RTL, SDC timing constraints, and PDC placement constraints. Also included is the gate level netlist if you wish to skip the synthesis part of the project and go straight to using ACE for place and route. The first step in compiling the design is synthesizing it in Synplify Pro. In the next part of this video, I'll show you how to create a new project, add the source files and any options, and compile the design to generate a gate level netlist. First, open the Synplify Pro tool by typing Synplify Pro in your Linux terminal window or by double-clicking on Synplify Pro or opening it from the Start menu on Windows. If an existing project opens, simply click on the Close Project button at the left. To create a new project, go to File, New Project. Next, add your source files by clicking on the Add File button on the left. First, add the technology-specific file. In this case, we will use the 7t_simplify.v file from libraries/device models. Next, we'll add the design files from the quick start design. In this case, it will be counter.v and quickstart.v. Then click OK. Synplify compiles the files in order, so it's important to make sure the last file in your list is the top-level module. Next, to set up any options, click on the Implementation Options button on the left. On the Device tab, choose the appropriate technology, part number, package, and speed grade. On the Options tab, you can choose any options. For this design, we will keep the defaults. On the Constraints tab, you can add the quickstart.sdc file. On the Implementation Results tab, you set the location of where you want the results written. For this design, we won't need to make any changes on the Timing Report tab. On the Verilog tab, we'll set the top-level module name. Here we'll add the device library include path. If you have any compiler directives, this is the location to add those as well. The GCC and place and route tabs can be ignored for this design. We'll be doing place and route in ACE. Once you have all your options set, click OK. Finally, click the big Run button here at the top left to compile your design. If you have any errors or warnings, read through your messages and fix anything if needed. Now that you have a netlist, you can begin the place and route portion of the flow. In this section of the video, I'll show you how to open ACE, create a new project, add source files and set options, and finally, run the flow to generate your bitstream. First, open ACE by typing ACE in your Linux terminal window or by double-clicking on ACE or opening it from the Start menu on Windows. If an existing project opens, simply right-click on the project and choose Remove. To create a new project, go to File, Create Project. Choose your project directory and a project name. In this case, we'll place it in our work directory and name the project Quick Start. You can add an implementation name or leave that blank for the default IMPL1 option, then click Finish. Next, add your source files by clicking File, Add Project Source Files, or click the Add Project Source Files button near the top. This will open up a dialog box. Browse to add your quick start.vma file netlist and click OK. Repeat the process to add quickstart.sdc for your timing constraints and quickstart.pdc for your placement constraints. Next, you want to set up any options. Go over to the Options window and expand the Design Preparation tab. Choose your target device. In this case, we will be choosing the AC7T1500. If you are using a different device, choose that one, but it must match the device you used to generate your netlist from Synplify Pro. Here you can also choose the package, speed grade, core voltage, and junction temperature. For this video, we will keep the default values. For our flow mode, we're planning to generate a bitstream, so you need to choose the normal flow mode. Feel free to investigate some of the other options available if you wish. For the quick start design, we will use the remaining default options. Now, go over to the flow window and press the play button to begin the flow. Once your flow is complete, you can check timing in the timing report, check utilization, and any other reports. Now you have successfully generated a bitstream for the quick start design. You should now know how to create and compile a project in Synplify Pro, as well as create a project in ACE and generate a bitstream. If you have any further questions or you run into any issues using our tools, please contact us at support@achronix.com. Thank you again for choosing Achronix.